नमस्ते। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर क्लासरूम ट्रांजैक्शन फॉर क्लास 4 कंपोनेंट वोकैबुलरी। माय ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर एनेबल द चिल्ड्रन टू नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इंसेक्ट्स एंड बर्ड्स, डेवलप डिडक्टिव वे ऑफ लर्निंग, मेक द चिल्ड्रन बी एंथुसियास्टिक अबाउट लर्निंग न्यू वर्ड्स, एनेबल द चिल्ड्रन आइडेंटिफाई विच नाउंस डू नॉट हैव प्लोरल फॉर्म्स एंड नो द ईजी वे ऑफ फॉर्मिंग प्लोरल फॉर्म्स। Before going to teach the lesson, I will show the picture chart. There are many birds and I will allow the children to speak about these birds. They will come with many answers and many of the children know about these birds. They will come out with answers. They know the sparrow, they know the hen, and I will ask some more questions regarding this chart. And now, if they do not know, I will help them. They will share the experiences with these birds. And next, I will show another chart. They also know about this mosquito. And I will ask some more questions and I will discuss with them about the insects, about the birds. So I will allow the children to observe the difference between the birds and insects. So, I will allow the children to list out the insects and birds. What are the insects? Have you seen cockroach, ant, butterfly, fly, and dragonfly, bee, and mosquito? Birds, what are the birds in the chart? Crow, sparrow, cuckoo, eagle, duck, hen, pigeon. Here, the purpose of this listing the birds and insects, they will know the spellings and they will differentiate, they will know the difference between the birds and the insects, and they collectively write and they collectively learn, and they will come out with some more insects and some more birds. They'll observe what is a bird and what is an insect. They will know the features of the birds and features of the insects and like that, so, external features. Here, they will come out and they will discuss some more things about the birds and insects. So, again, for their observation, to test their observation, I write some words and phrases on the board. Small in size, delicate, beak, feathers, needle, three pairs of legs, two legs, nests. I will discuss with them. I will tell the meanings in mother tongue also. And then I write two headings, birds and insects. So among these words or phrases, what are appropriate? Which phrase is appropriate with these headings? They have to come out with answers. This is an activity. Feathers. Which creature has the feather? Birds. What are the small in size? Insects. So in observation, they will come out with answers. In birds, beak. Birds have beak. But in this, it is delicate. They will list out. They will write the words and phrases under correct headings. This is also good activity to draw out the attention of the children, whether they are observing properly or not, and they will definitely come out with answers. It is an activity. Next, before going to read the lesson, I'll engage the children with a language game. Here, dear children, I utter some birds and names. Birds names and insects names. When I utter a bird, you have to raise your left hand and raise your hand, right hand when I utter insect. So if I say dragonfly, the student has to raise right hand. If I say an eagle, the student has to raise his left hand. So rapidly, with briskly, I utter some words. Basing on that words, the student has to raise their right hand and left hand. So this is the right activity to draw out the attention of the children. As they know the insects and birds, they will enjoy this game. Some may not respond properly, and they will correct themselves and follow the other students. It is an activity. The students also will play the same game at their leisure hours. Next, see the three butterflies. Three butterflies lived in a garden. They were friends. One of them was white, one red, and the other yellow. They played and danced together. They flew together and sucked nectar from the flower. Nectar, where do we get nectar? Nectar, we get nectar from flowers. It is very sweet. The three butterflies feed on nectar. Where do we get nectar? In flowers. Yeah, very good. One afternoon, when the butterflies were playing in the garden, it suddenly grew dark and a cold wind blew. It's going to rain. Let's stop playing, said the red butterfly. Suddenly, it started raining and three butterflies got wet in the rain. Everybody gets wet in rain. So the butterflies are very, very delicate. They are going to get wet. They found it difficult to fly. The rain is heavy, so they cannot fly because they are very, very delicate, no? They looked for shelter. They saw a sunflower nearby. It was watching them curiously. Hello, sunflower. It's raining heavily. Can we stay here till it stops raining? Asked the butterflies. The sunflower said, my favorite, red and yellow ones, you can stay with me till it stops raining. But I can't let the white one in here. Oh, what a selfish one it is. Very bad sunflower. The yellow and the red butterflies replied, no, dear, we won't stay here, sending away our friend in dismay. See, what a good friendship. See, the two butterflies denied the offer of sunflower because they are good friends. They won't leave white one alone. So the rain came down like pebbles on the butterflies. Oh my God. These raindrops are just like pebbles on the butterflies. They can't bear. So then the butterflies saw a white lily. Hello, good lily, it's raining heavily. Open your petals wide and take us in to hide, the butterflies begged. My favorite white one, you can stay with me till it stops raining. But I can't let the other two of you here, said the white lily. It is also selfish one. No, dear, I won't stay here, sending away my friends in dismay. I replied the white butterfly. See, it is also replied the same. So the three butterflies are the best friends. This is the example. See, the butterflies were totally wet by then, and it was very difficult for them to fly. Poor butterflies. They looked at the sky. It was still cloudy. The sun was watching the butterflies from behind the clouds. He was pleased to see the love and care among the butterflies. The sun was so pleased. It was very happy. So he chased the clouds away and it stopped raining. The sun dried the butterfly's wings. See how good he is. Sun God has dried the butterfly's wings. The three butterflies were happy again. They danced in the garden among the flowers till evening. When night fell, the three butterflies went to sleep together. So this is the story. And after that, I will ask some questions like this. How many plural forms are there in the lesson? I will let the students pick the words, plural words. So they will come out with answers. And again, I will ask the students to observe whether they have, what are the words have plural forms. Can we say darts? Can we say flues? Can we say playings? And can we say grooves? Why? Why? Why don't we say darks? Why don't we say flues? Why don't we say playings? I will ask the children. And they have to observe and know the fact, because the plural forms possess, the nouns only possess the plural forms. They will come out after observation. Which words have chance for plural forms? I will ask the children and they will find out the reason. Which words have plural forms? So they will understand only the nouns have plural forms. It's playing is a verb. It doesn't have any plural form. Good, it is an adjective. It doesn't have any plural forms. So after drawing out the responses among the children and observations only, I will allow the children to learn themselves which words have the plural forms. This is my objective. I will try to fulfill this objective by asking some questions and eliciting responses by giving different questions. See, here some words are there in the lesson. They are all nouns. Yes, they are all nouns. Garden. What is the plural form of garden? Gardens. Friend, friends. Flower, flowers. Shelter, shelters. Sunflower, sunflowers. Lily, lilies. Petal, petals. Cloud, clouds. Major share of the plural forms formed by adding s. Yes. Now some words do not have the same rule. Here see foot. If it is one foot. If there are two foot, shall we say foots? No. The plural form of foot is feet. Here you see mouse. Mouse. What is the plural form of mouse? Not mouses. Mice. Here. See, some are different. See, here one rose is here. Three roses. Monkey. Monkeys. Elephant. Elephants. It's common. It's some words, many of the words, many of the plural forms can be formed by adding simply s. Here, this is a picture. Here is a heap of sugar. This is sugar. It is also a noun. But here you see three heaps of sugar. So can we say sugars? Is it correct to say sugars? No. This is sugar, and whatever it is sugar. We have to say sugar. There is no plural form for the sugar. See, here is water. Here, two waters. Can we say two waters? No, no, no. We should not say two waters. Water has no plural form. So here we have to say water. Here see one heap of rice. Can we here see two heaps of rice? Shall we say, is it correct to say two rices? No. I have to say rice only. There is no plural form for the rice. What have you observed, children? Here it is water, rice and sugar. These are all, what are all these? These are material. So the materials do not have any plural forms. But here you see, here is water. But where is the water? Water is there in the bottle. Yes. How many bottles are there? Three bottles of water. We can say three bottles of water. We should not say three waters. Here see rice. Earlier we saw only rice, but here what we see? Here a bag of rice. A bag of rice. How many bags of rice are there? Two bags of rice. Yes, we can say two bags of rice. We should not say two rices. Okay, you see sugar. It is sugar. So there is no plural form for the sugar. Sugars, we should not say sugars. Here, three bowls of sugar. Three bowls of sugar. This is the way of forming plural forms. See, as we learn the lesson, I am going to give you some puzzle, some grids. I have given some grids. You know the words which are there in the box. See, garden, cloud, box, fan, lily, night, poem, schools. Here, form the plural forms. Here, see, night. What is the plural form of night? Nights. You can write here. Next, see, garden. What is the plural form of these? Gardens. Yes, I have given you two hints. I have filled two grids. Remaining words are to be filled by you. Yeah. See, here it is very simple. As you know, we have learned in the lesson. So, we can, students, you fill all the grids. Okay. You have to write plural forms of these words. Okay, na? Right. Next, see, all words have the do not have the same rule. See, it is box, boxes, bench, benches, dish, dishes, truss, trusses. See, I will let the children read these words several times and ask the children to observe. What have they observed? Discuss. I will allow the children to discuss. So they will come to a conclusion that many of the plural words can be formed after adding es. I should not say in beginning. After observation only they will tell. This is box, boxes, bench, benches, es. By adding es to the word, they can form plural forms. So I will allow the children to learn some more plural form for adding es. See, some are different. Leaf, leaves, foot, feet. These are to be taught by me, and I will teach these words, the plural forms of these, and I will give some homework regarding this vocabulary. Thank you. Let the children fill the classroom is an address of happiness. Thanks for listening.